Congresswoman Maria Elvira Salazar of Florida. She sits on the House Foreign Affairs Committee, and she is the daughter of Cuban exiles. Welcome to you, Congresswoman.
And thank you very much. And your words were words of wisdom. And I was also very lucky I won that same lottery by being born here, thanks to my grandparents and to my parents, that they made that ultimate sacrifice of coming to the United States in search for freedom. So bravo to your words. I agree fully. Because, like you said, you need to go abroad and see what happens outside and travel so you will have a point of reference and you will know what this American exceptionality is all about. And like you said, people that are risking their lives. I was a news reporter many years before I won my seat in Congress, and I interviewed family after family, people that had lost relatives eaten by the sharks in the Florida Straits because they were trying to make the trek from Havana to Miami.
Well, Congresswoman, one country I have not been to is Cuba. So I need you to tell us and our viewers, tell me what Cuba is like and has been like under the Castro rule.
Well, I can summarize that in telling you that the Castro and the Cuban Revolution has been the most cruel and the most evil revolution that the Americas has seen ever since the arrival of Christopher Columbus. No one has been able to be crueler and take the repression to scientific levels. That is what the Castros, I'm sure they're going to write history, and the historians will look back and say these people not only were able to gain power but maintain it under the most cruel and severe repression. But the good news is that right now, after 62 years, those people who have lost everything, their families, their food, medicine, Cubans have nothing. They are starving. And now they lost their fear. And that's why we see them, that we have seen them for 7 days out into the streets, thousands and thousands of Cubans facing torture, facing death, facing jail, anything. And now the United States needs to step up, and specifically President Biden needs to redress that historical betrayal that happened during Bay of Pigs. This is the moment when the Democratic administration, and I am a Republican congresswoman, but it doesn't matter. The Democrats have the historical duty right now to redress what happened in Bay of Pigs and say, yes, Cubans, we are with you. How? Well, by just turning on the internet. And why internet right now is the most urgent step? Because that way we'll embolden, we'll let the people of Cuba know that they're not alone and that they can go out back into the street, more and more people, and demand freedom. And then we will be watching, the whole world will be watching how they're treated, how they're tortured, how they're being beaten on the streets. And that will change everything because the Cubans lost the fear.
Congresswoman, what is your reaction when some on the left, either sporting figures or politicians, say it was really America's policies, our embargo, that hurt the Cuban people and not the Castro regime?
Trey, the problem is that, unfortunately, our American colleagues are ignorant about what really happens with this embargo. Let me just give you some empirical evidence. Cuba trades with 180 countries, Canada, Mexico, Europeans, the Arabs. Cuba trades with everyone, number one. Number two, we send $3 billion, B with billion dollars, from Miami and from the Cuban exile community to Cuba. $3 billion. They are flooded with cash because of us, dollars. Number three, we, the United States, will sell to Cuba. Probably we're the most important trade partners with Havana. All the chicken they eat and the different poultry. So what embargo? The embargo is the one imposed. The Castros are the ones who have imposed the embargo on the Cubans. Why? Because the fishermen cannot sell their fish. That has nothing to do with the American embargo. The farmers cannot sell their crops to the Cuban population. That has nothing to do with the embargo. You cannot open up a cafeteria, a beauty parlor, or a hardware store. That has nothing to do with the embargo. That has to do with the fact that the Castros are in the business of power. And they have been all along. And unfortunately, they have done such a great job in strangling that population. But now they're saying no more. And where are we? The United States. So that's why, as a congresswoman from the city of Miami, the heart of the Cuban exile community, and my senators, Marco Rubio, Rick Scott, Bob Menendez, Albio Sierras, Carlos Jimenez, all these are members of Congress. We're asking, we're begging President Biden to receive us in the White House so we can help him and explain to him what's really happening. And now I am appealing to President Biden. You are a man of God. Last time I saw you, you told me that you were Irish Catholic. Well, the same God that you have is the same God that I have. And my people need your help. This is an audience of one. President Biden. And then the White House says that they're reviewing the policy. What is there to review? People are out on the street demanding libertad. And the White House is saying, well, we have to review. It's impossible what's happening. But I do believe, and I do believe in the God Almighty, that will touch the heart of President Joe Biden. And we're going to see a change from the White House next week.
Congresswoman, if I understand you correctly, your simple request is that President Biden meet with you and Senator Rubio and Senator Scott and Senator Menendez and others so you can share with him one-on-one how he can help the Cuban people. That seems like a pretty small request.
That's one. And the second one is to turn on the internet. Either from Guantanamo Naval Base, we can put a tower, and or American Embassy, the United States Embassy in Havana. Why? Because they have the capability. It's not that I want the Cubans to watch Netflix in perfect video quality. All I'm saying, and the whole congressional delegation is asking, so the Cubans can upload the video, and then we can continue showing to the world what the regime is doing to them. That's basically it now. You know why, Trey? Because the moment this happens, the Cubans will know that the Americans are watching. And when they know that the Americans are watching, then they will go out into the street more and more and more. And when you have millions, hundreds of thousands of Cubans on the street, there's no regime that can support that or that can stand that. And then that will be chapter number two in history. We're still in chapter number one, and we need to finish it well. And who can write it well? The President of the United States, President Biden.
Well, Congresswoman, thank you. Your passion for the Cuban people and for freedom is evident to everyone watching.
So
thank you for that.
Good, yes, sir.
Good luck to you getting
Thanks.
That meeting, and thank you for being with us tonight. Yes, ma'am.